Greetings, friend. Timberlake here. I'm starting a new Sudoku series. I'm going to talk about Set Equivalence Theory. It was really popular like 7-10 months ago. You saw it on Cracking the Cryptic. A few people mentioned it, like Phil Newman and Rangsk in the Sudokult discussion. There's a great video by Shye who also talks about Set, and I'll put links to those videos below. But I want to kind of get into, like, how do you use Set Equivalence Theory to solve Sudokus? What is it? I want to kind of explore that a little bit more because I had a hard time like grasping how to actually apply it to Sudoku puzzle. Before I get in too much of that though, I wanted to show you a little bit of Set from a puzzle that's already been completed to kind of show how it works. I think with the number showing, it might be a little bit easier to see what I'm talking about. The idea behind Set is that we know that Sudoku has, you know, the digits 1 through 9 in every block, right? And also has the digits 1 through 9 in every column and in every row. Okay, we get that, right? And the thing we know here is if this intersects, this digit's the same, right? So what we can say is these 8 digits in the light, in the dark blue, are the same as these 8 digits in the light blue. Okay, got it. All right, conversely, all 9 of the digits have to be found right there. Okay, so that's kind of the idea is now these rows and columns, you can make them equivalent to something else to help solve puzzle. So let me get rid of this and this. And I'm in F puzzles, by the way, because what I normally use Sudoku, it's not really good for using colors like this. It's a little too clunky. So if you look right here and you see that there's an intersection of this row and this block. And so really easy to see is that these 3 digits, 2, 6, 9 intersect, right? So what we know is that these 6 digits remaining, 1, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, have to be the same as these 6 digits, the 1, 4, 5, 3, 7, 8. And this is kind of the basis of Set, going, you know, if these weren't filled out, you could look at here and go, okay, which one of these is missing that must go in this green part? Okay, cool. Now, if we have another block down here. Okay, so if you added these digits here in the blue and these down here in the green, same idea. You know, this 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 is the same as 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 right there. But then what you could also say is that these 12 blue digits contain the same as these 12 green. And that's the kind of the basis. If you know what's in the blue, it can help you solve what's in the green. And I'll do one more kind of a slash here. Let's say that we want to add, you know, this column in the green, right? And then we want to add this row into the blue. So what you're going to do is you're still going to take out anything that overlaps, because we know it's in both. We don't care about the ones that are in both. And now you see this kind of funky display here, right? But what I can tell you is that all these green, the same exact digits are in the blue and vice versa. And that's why I have all the digits showing, because kind of show you real quick. You know, 1, 3, let's kind of eliminate everything in the green here, right? 1, 3, 7, 8. And so we can get rid of that and 1. All right, so that's your 1, 3, 7, 8 gone. 4, 5, 7, 8. Get rid of that 4, 5. This 7 and this 8, right? Okay, 3, 4, 5, 9. 3, 4, 5, and the 9. And what do you have left? 2, 6, 3. 2, 6, 3. See how that works? And hopefully the kind of visualizing that will get you to understand this is how we're going to apply Set to the puzzle I'm about to show you. But before we get to that, I wanted to give you a brand new announcement. I have created a Buy Me a Coffee page. So it's kind of like Patreon, but a little bit smaller degree. The idea is if you like what I'm doing here, help support the channel so I can keep making great new content. So I'll put a link in the video description and on my About page. So you go into Buy Me a Coffee, and I'm at this stage right now, if you buy a coffee, which is a you know, set for like a $5, about the same as a cup of coffee, you'll help support the channel. I'm also setting a goal that if I get at least $25, my first thing I want to start adding and offering to people is I will start making personalized solving videos. You can send me a puzzle to solve and I will make you a video specific to you and I'll send it to you privately. Sound cool? Great. I'm excited about this. I'm excited about being able to reach and support you more on the Smart Hobbies channel through Buy Me a Coffee. Now, let's get back to the solving video. Okay, here's our puzzle for today. This is the easiest puzzle I could find to kind of show you how Set works in the easiest format. This is called TT Crate Dino. It's by Philip Newman. It is an easy puzzle. It kind of looks like the Tatooine Sunset and Sunrise, but Philip made this one to be easy. And the point here is not that Set's the best way to solve this puzzle. You can go through and use just naked hidden singles, basically, and get through this entire puzzle. If you want to do that, there's a link below. Go right ahead. The point I want to show you is it's an excellent first puzzle to understanding Set. And so what you're looking for and why this puzzle is set up so well for it is you have clumps of the same types of digits in certain rows and certain columns. So let's go across rows 2, row 5, and row 8. What do you notice? What digits are contained in these rows? 1s, 2s, and 3s, right? All the same digits, 1, 2s, and 3s. Great. Now, what you'll see is that there's digits that haven't been contained in that. But what you'll notice in these columns is you see the digits 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 all in the white here. So by applying Set, we can come here and we can make a deduction about this puzzle. Now what you want to do is you want to get rid of the intersecting cells because they're going to be the same in both, and that's not what we're trying to determine, right? All right. Now you see this kind of weird Christmassy grid thing, right? But here's the cool thing about Set. How many digits do we have in orange that are already filled out? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, right? And they're 1s, 2s, and 3s. How many blank spaces do we have in the purple? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And do any of the orange repeat with the purple? No. So what we know is that these 9 digits, the 1s, 2s, and 3s, have to be in the purple cells because this is equivalent. And it can't be the white ones because those are the intersecting ones. And they can't be outside of it. And they're not part of the 4, 5, 6, 7. So you can fill all 9 of these purple with 1s, 2s, and 3s. And now I am going to have, I will take out the red ones, which means those aren't applicable for those cells. But I'm kind of trying to make a point here. Conversely, let's look at the purple, right? How many purples do we have filled out? 9. How many cells do we have in orange that are not filled out yet? 9, right? 3 here, 3 here, and 3 here. And they're none of these are the same. Guess what? We can fill out 4, 5, 6, and 7 for all of these orange cells. Philip Newman talks a little bit about this. The idea is if you can, you know, the ideal puzzle for doing Set is one that has a lot of clumps of the same digits in the same rows and columns like this did. And usually it requires like a swordfish pattern. That's why a lot of his tattooing type puzzles are good for it. And the constraint is such that the missing cells from one color, so that, you know, like there's 9 missing cells in purple, can be filled out by the known cells in the other color. So we know there's 9 here, 9 there. And so when you have that kind of a constraint, Set works really, really well. And now we can solve this puzzle by using Set. And again, if you want to just solve it regularly, you'll get through it pretty quick and that's cool. But I wanted to show you how we now solve the puzzle with Set. And so I'm getting rid of all the red because those are the ones that can't be. See how there's a 7 right there, so it can't be a 7. There's a 4 or 5 right there. And so what you'll notice right away is this can only be what's in here. So this can only be a 3. And this can only be a 2, and this can only be a 1. You come up here, that can only be a 1 or 2 or 3. We already proved all this, and this is a 1, 2, or 3. And look at it, now we've filled out all those purple cells just like that. Pretty cool, huh? All right, and then you could go and you could start just filling out the ones pretty easily. So you have a one and a one. So the one's right here. It can't be in this cell because that can only be 4, 6, or 7. And so now 1, 1, you can fill out a one right there. 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Okay, all the ones are done. And let's look at the twos. 2, 2. That has to be 2 because of this 2 right here. And then 2, 2, 2 because that 2 right there. And then you got 2, 2, and a 2. Now all the twos are done. All right, let's go to threes. 3, 3. This has to be a 3. That can't be a 3. 3, 3, 3. 3, 3. Here's your 3 right here. And then a 3, 3, 3. Cool. Now all the threes are done. And so we did all that. And now we can kind of move on and solve the rest of the puzzle. I'll keep the, well, I can get rid of the colors now because they're not really serving a use. Just you don't add on any more. So you won't add any more candidates into those cells. And I'm not going to add any more candidates anyway. I'm going to do the rest of this without doing any more marks. So what you notice right here is this 4, 6, 7 makes a naked triple. And so we only have one missing spot, you know, and that's an 8. All right. Other things we can notice, you have a 5 coming up here, 5 there, so this has to be a 5. And then now what does that do to your 4? So 4 coming up, column 8 and coming across, and so that has to be a 4. All right, so then we have a 6, 7, 6, 7. And then did you, you know, just kind of work your way through the puzzle here as we start solving the rest of these candidates. It's kind of fun, I'll be honest with you. Yeah, I guess I will do a couple of marks here. So you got a 7, 9 here, 7, 9 there, right? You can look here, this 8, 9 coming across. This has to be an 8, 9. That has to be an 8, 9. And then what do you have in the rest of this row, right? 6, 8, 9. So that's a 6, 9. And this is a 6, 8. And this is a 6, 7, 8. So this is a triple, and so you can actually solve that for a 4. And now this has to be a 4, 4, 4, 4. You got 4, 4, 4. And you see, you just kind of keep moving yourself down the puzzle, 7, 8, 9. So, and then now what you have right here is, so you see how these sevens are now a pointing pair? That's no longer a 7, right? And so, where can the 7 be? Only gonna be in one spot right there, which leaves this as a 5, 6. Right there, cool. And then what you have here is, that can't be a 5, so now that has to be your 5. Awesome, and so you have a 6, 9 pair right there, 6, 7, 7, 8, 8, 9. Okay, cool. Okay, so look at the 5s. You got a 5 and a 5 and a 5 coming across here. So this has to be a 5. And now you'll probably notice you can't have a 5 here, 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 or here. So that's the only 5 left in column 3, which makes this a 6. Now you have a 5, 7 naked pair. So what's left? 8 or 9. You got an 8 up there. So that's a 9. And that's an 8. And again, you know, the puzzle wasn't that hard to begin with, but you saw how we got a nice jump here by using set. And so now 8, one of these, this has to be an 8 now. And then this has to be an 8, which makes this a 6. That's a 7. That's an 8. That's a 6. I love it when I can use my notation. That's a 9. So this is your 7. That's your 9. Here's your 7. Here's your 9. Here's your 6. There's your 5, 9, 7, 6, 9, 8. And you see how the puzzle just kind of falls apart. All right. You know, you can kind of work along with me as we're filling out the rest of these cells. That's a 4. That's a 6. Okay, what do we have here? We got an 8, 8, 8, 8, and then we'll fill out 7, 7, there's your 7, this is your 9, we have right there, that's your 6, and our last digit is a 4. Sudoku's been solved. So, I wanted to show you how set worked there. That's kind of cool, huh? It's neat. And so, yeah, try it out for yourself. Kind of get yourself familiar with it. I plan to do more set puzzles of a little bit more increasing difficulty puzzle-wise and some applications set a little bit more than just this basic application I just showed you here. Let me know what you thought in the comments. If you want to support this channel, Click on the Buy Me a Coffee link in the description below. I want to offer you some additional value, and this will help me do it. I do appreciate you supporting the channel any way you can. Also, like, comment, subscribe to more hobbies. You don't miss any new content. You can check out some of these other videos. Maybe you missed them from the month of Sudoku last month. Thank you all so much for watching.